why I buy C and D properties in A and B locations. Good to see you again. Today we're going to talk about why I buy C and D properties in A and B locations. Right now we're in downtown Safety Harbor. Really great area, has a good school district, one of the lowest crime rates in the nation. We're one block from the water, we're right next to the spa, the park, we have everything here. Why I buy A and B locations is, and normally I buy in A and B locations prior to them being A and B. I find great area with specific features, close to the water, great parks, things you cannot replicate other places. And the areas being a B and an A, you can't generate an ocean. You can't generate waterfront property. You can't create an awesome park. Possibly could be done, but extremely difficult, very expensive. Now, if you're in Dubai, yeah, you could spend billions of dollars to create an ocean and waterfront property. But overall, an area cannot automatically generate these type of things. So I look for properties that have great downtown markets, close to the water, good school districts, low crime rates. That is very difficult to change. Is it able to be done? Yes, but you would need to have a large bank account to be able to change it, because you would have to buy out majority of the neighborhood to change things. What you can change is an ugly home to a beautiful home. I buy C, D, F properties in A and B locations, because what I realized in back in the day, I used to buy properties in not the best neighborhood, but had the building itself had good bones, and I would upgrade the building even more. The issue that I ran into is I couldn't upgrade the area. No matter how nice I made the property, and no matter how much I tried to help, I couldn't get people to pay more rent or even the little rent I was charging. It was really difficult. I kept on having to lower rent and to find very good people that weren't paying a lot of rent, but at least were paying it consistently. So now I try to find properties with good bones. Sometimes they do have it, sometimes they don't. But at the same time, the area is so good that I could put in a lot of money. I bought this for 300 grand, put in over 200 grand into the property. And now it's worth close to $1 million. So you can't upgrade the area, but you can upgrade the property. Now this property is an A property, has Cat 6 wire throughout. If you guys don't know what Cat 6 wire is, it's internet connection. You can actually connect your laptop directly to the wall, so you have direct feed instead of going through the WAPs. If you don't know what WAPs are, it's wireless access, Wi-Fi. It has cable throughout in all the rooms. It has upgraded electric, plumbing, AC, brand new windows and doors. So the whole property is insulated. It has everything you want in a brand new home, but in a historic 1925 home, great Fort Lauderdale feel in a downtown market that is so rare and so desired, so people are willing to pay for it. Now you take this home and move it into a C and D neighborhood, you couldn't invest that type of money. You couldn't even sell it for what it cost you to put it together. This property is close to probably 600 grand. I couldn't even sell it for 600 grand. Now that's unfortunate, but the reality is you're paying for this with your pocket. So I don't want you to lose any money. So make sure that when you're adding and you're upgrading a property, do not over invest compared to what the neighborhood is. Because despite how amazing you made it, people can only afford a certain amount of money in that neighborhood. So you have to be able to provide them what's affordable and manageable for them. So that's the next thing. You don't give them certain features in a home that they can't maintain. Otherwise, it's just gonna get destroyed. If you like this video, smash the like button and follow the channel. As always, guys, invest in the front end, save in the back end, and make a lot of money. I'll see you next time.